Welcome back, Zero K fans, to 2v2 tournament. We've finally gotten some of the sub situations sorted out, and I've also got Floris with me.
Hey, good morning, or good evening, or good night, wherever you are.
So, Sandro and Chadwo didn't show up. Irie and Edgewedike didn't show up. All of them have been disqualified. Norm0616 actually apparently wasn't there for the longest time, just didn't know how to join IRC channels, has now learned. That has been rectified. Skazi and Orphelius were also here for the longest time. And Sino and Killer are here, but Moj and Ralhop are not, so they are getting subbed. Moj and Ralhop are getting subbed in, probably Forever and Icons are being subbed in, respectively. And that should probably be happening at the same time. We're going to be going over Anarchid Yurga versus Norm0616 RyMarq. And it's going to start on Altair Crossing. Once they get it all sorted out. Oh, Moj is here, actually. Moj has arrived.
The Moj has arrived.
Okay, so I guess only one sub. Whatever. I don't know. Whatever.
So again, who do you want in this match?
This is Anarchid Yurga versus Norm0616 RyMarq. This is the semifinals.
Completely disqualified. They haven't been substituted, Sandro and Shadow.
Okay. No, Sandro and Shadow are gone. Like I said, they're...
So it's a bye for Norm and RyMarq.
Correct.
Okay.
Straight into semifinals.
Okay. Still best of three.
Yep.
The finals are best of five?
Finals are best of five, as usual. And of course, all single elimination, so this is... yeah, kind of a thing. Well, at this point, double elim would have been completely wonky because it would have been all these guys been knocked to... just totally disqualified and then knocked out, and then it would have been... that would have been odd. Anyway. Yeah, at this point, we're only missing Ralhop of the non-disqualified players. Assuming that Moj was not disqualified. And why are Anakin and Yuri taking a while to start up? Okay, now we are just about set up. As soon as we get... okay, there we go. So yeah, we're setting up. It'll be an Altair Crossing. This is a map that we've shown before. This is a map that's very, very reclaim heavy.
Yes, it is. Lots of trees, lots of rocks. But we'll see that in a moment as the game, when the game has started.
Yes, we will. As soon as... well, I'm pretty sure... yeah. Go.
The elo difference was too big. The room wouldn't start.
Yeah, that happens commonly. But that's why they have 4-start command. There is a way to start any game. Any and all games can be started at will.
Minus F. Boom.
So we're going to be... now we're going to be getting into the game once it loads.
Ah, there's Killer.
Killer should be playing with whoever's subbing in for Ralhop pretty soon.
Yep.
Like, now. Okay, Mojino and Icon's Killer, that's going to have... that's what's going to happen. So just for a reference, that's what's happening in Group D. But now the map has been loaded, we can get back to that. So it looks like Anarchid and Yurga are starting out along the east side of the map. Sorry, west side of the map. Norm0616 and RyMarq starting on the east side of the map. And Altair Crossing, as mentioned before, very reclaim heavy. Be obvious.
Indeed. I see shields and I see jumpers.
Yeah, we have Norm0616 going for Shieldbot Factory, which is not surprising. But center Jumpbot from RyMarq, that's actually... I'm a bit surprised they haven't flipped. Like, RyMarq is not doing Jumpbot at the south, and Norm doing Shield in the center. I would think that Shields would be much more of a center factory. You'd want to have just having that defensive wall.
Mm-hmm.
Being able to very easily get things around. Whereas the Jumpbot Factory, you can kind of start anywhere. And
they're not that fast.
They aren't that fast, but it's more of the sneaky factory. I don't really see it as being the frontline defensive factory that Shieldbot would be much more suited to being.
Yeah, well, I think there are plenty of options.
Well, Yurga's going for heavy tanks, which is a very surprising strategy, and Anarchid also going for corner Shieldbot.
Not a single Cloaky factory.
Which is actually not that surprising. The Shieldbot factory is what I'd expect in this map, just given that it is a slightly smaller map. It's more choke point heavy. Cloakybot can work, definitely, but...
scouts with dirtbags, that's good and cheap.
Yep, commons.
Godachi's.
I'm open right there.
Always find Godachi's very... Ah, I see Christmas hats. Ah.
Oh, yes, it is December. We do have the Christmas hats. I didn't really point that out before, but yes. Commanders get Christmas hats in December. It's like very, very, very geometric Christmas hats.
But what I wanted to say was the Kodachi, because of his long reload time and big projectile, you're likely to hit trees, and then you waste a lot of... you get a lot of randomness in raiding.
Yep. Anyway, we have Anarchid coming in with the very early bandits just to defend against Rymark's Pyro. Doing a pretty poor job, actually. Pyro managing to get away. Rymark is something
lost
of an
three
expert.
Bandits. Wow.
Yeah, Rymark is something of an expert in jump bots. They know what they're doing with jump bots. That is their main factory, is jump bots.
Hmm.
Yeah, which is a little bit surprising given that they're also the ones in charge of the whole sea rebalance project. But yeah, they're jump bot mains, pretty much. So I'm not surprised.
Let's see what
its
Kodachi can do.
Well, Kodachi should be able to get free metal extractor. Oh, not quite free metal extractor, but...
Not much happening
shot.
There.
And the Kodachi itself is not harmed. Norm's going to have to worry about it, though. It's going to have to get around. It's going to be tricky. These bandits wisely avoiding it, but at the same time, unwisely clumping up. Waiting until getting their reinforcements before coming in, and... That actually... Ooh, getting it caught in the rock, but not
quite
enough.
Yeah. Come on, 98.
Oh, and it's moving in right into the bandit concave, but not enough. Oh,
gets and a lot... There's a bunch of other bandit deaths.
Yeah, but quite a few of them have survived, and they're all getting repaired, which is very good to see.
Now, I see two constructors from Yurga already reclaiming. Our Norm RyMarq team isn't really using that aspect of this map.
Yeah, they're playing very much... They're playing to the terrain, but they are not playing to the gimmick. They are not playing to the reclaim, which is really surprising. I'm actually a bit surprised that neither player has been really playing that heavily. I mean, Yurga
but
is
they do
reclaiming,
have,
but...
The South Metal, the South Maxis, which is a good income.
They do, but the thing is those trees are huge for saving money on power plants. Like, anytime you see someone like Google Frog in particular, almost always does this. Like, he just grabs the trees. Doesn't really worry about the rocks, but the trees definitely. But then Google Frog doesn't really like building power plants if they don't have to.
No, you shouldn't build anything you don't have to, in general.
Yeah, but it's power plants in particular I notice when he's playing, but that's not so important right now. Google Frog's not playing in this, and...
No, he isn't.
Anarchid, also kind of surprisingly, though, not going for anything very sneaky. I mean, this outlaw wasn't a bad thing, though. That was somewhat sneaky, so I'll give him that. Yeah, Anarchid, I find, normally goes for much sneakier strategies, and this is going for shield bot opener, kind of straightforward. They're doing what they can, though, with the outlaw thug, but even then, that's...
It's a small victory, but they did lose some of their
thug.
Income there.
Still, that was a good shot. That was... Got rid of a metal extractor, got rid of a couple power plants, took out the northeast. I mean, that's a position that's basically RyMarq has to rebuild it, spend a lot of money to do so. And Yurga and Anarchid are fairly solid. At this point, they haven't been attacked. They have got some defenses around. They have units around in position to defend. And Norm is going to test those defenses. Coming in with a couple, about half dozen bandits, or almost a dozen bandits. And actually finding weak spots. Center of the map is actually a very weak spot for Yurga. Nothing is here to defend against it. There's a banisher, however, that's going to try.
No, but he didn't get the construct. He got a half a constructed laser turret, so it's not a real weak spot, and I didn't do much. And this is a waste.
Yeah,
this is a bit
this
too
is
opportunistic.
Although, actually, I don't know. It might work. The thugs will not have any time hitting.
Well, it's a nice pickup.
Yeah, got rid of the caretaker. That was a big blow, and a metal extractor is going to go down, possibly two. Yeah, the thug's not in range for the second one, and that is going to be two metal extractors. That bandit has done a decent job. And another Lotus is it going to come down? No, it's not going to matter, though, because once again, yet another metal extractor going down. And this banisher as well in the center of the map, but...
Did you see the jack jump out of the placeholder?
No, unfortunately, I missed that.
That was right... pretty funny. Oh, there's a commander of Anarchid that might die to the jack now.
The jack is going to try to trap it. Getting it on the right side too, so it's much easier for any further forces of RyMarq to come in and get rid of Anarchid's commander. Anarchid's commander is about to go down, and that is Anarchid's commander dead. So at this point, Anarchid and Yurga are slightly behind for economy, but only slightly, and this map has so much reclaim it almost doesn't matter.
It does matter. Reclaim stops working at some point, which is about now.
Oh yeah, that's true. All the rocks are gone. RyMarq has taken all of them. So yes, actually, Anarchid and Yurga has taken all of them, RyMarq. RyMarq's taken none of them. But yeah, RyMarq and Norm can actually still work with reclaim. Anarchid and Yurga, not so much. Not in their territory. So that was a big blow at the right time.
Quite funny to see how Norm relies on bandits exclusively and just two racketeers. But those racketeers are a good addition to this to his army to deal with heavy tanks.
Well, yeah, racketeers are—they're a perfect choice. I mean, when considering the fact that it's heavy tanks, I mean, racketeers are they're the counter. And I guess the banisher is really the only threat at this point. Like the Reaper isn't really much of a threat; it can't hit the bandits. Or it's so hard
disarmed.
To do so.
The Banisher is disarmed and he might lose it now.
Yep, definitely going to lose it. Down it goes. The Welder's going down as well. There's another Banisher in back, but it doesn't matter so much. And it's just a matter of time before that Reaper goes down. Though there is a repair force coming in trying to help out, but even then two bandits.
It is stuck, the tank. That's why I don't like tanks or vehicles in general. You cannot
and
end up in situations like this. This is a big loss for a tank player. If you lose two expensive tanks like this, it is disarmed again.
That was almost 2,000 metal worth of tanks that went down to about 500 metal worth of bandits. That is a massive blow. And especially when you consider that Yurga and Anarchid are actually ahead economically slightly. But even then, it's just... Yeah. Norm is managing to get through this. They're being sneaky in the right spots. They're putting in the right... This is... Like, in the last game, people were asking what it was... This is my... Oh, I'm feeling sick, voice, Kazi. Anyway, people were asking me in the last game what could be done for Ottawar and Parzival to win against Anarchid and Yurga. This sort of stuff here. Hitting the weak points, getting the right type counters, playing your absolute best factor. I mean, RyMarq being a jump bot specialist helps out quite a lot because jump bots are not used very commonly, so... While Anarchid and Yurga are expert players, they probably don't encounter as many jump bots as they do shields or cloakies or light vehicles.
It's also that, as you can see, Norm and RyMarq are actually working together in the south battle.
Yeah.
That's why they have a slight advantage there, but it's also why there's a shield ball and contested in the north.
It's a small shield ball, but yes, it does exist. Anarchid is moving forward. Yurga losing a lot of units, but Anarchid is taking advantage of that opening. And Anarchid has the largest army by cost. Although once the sumo comes up, it will be a little bit hard to actually compute by cost. It's going to become really weird afterwards. But for the moment, yeah, it's... Anarchid does have the military advantage.
Yes, Norm is ahead economically. They do have bigger income, but army-wise, Anarchid's team is a bit ahead. And they might lose the north now.
Oh, that's a bit tricky. If the placeholder hits the felon, then it's going to be a mass. That's going to stop it.
There is not much to.
And the placeholder does not hit the felon. It misses completely. Jack comes in. That's going to drain all the felon shields, and that should get rid of it. That shield ball's.
Oh, then it's disarmed.
Oh, that was close. And the placeholder apparently getting locked in its own black hole. But yeah, that was painful. And now. All the shield ball getting locked in that black hole, and it does not matter. That must be really annoying right now. Because at this point, RyMarq can't really do much about the north. They're either going to try to punch through the center while keeping Yurga's forces completely contained. Or at least basically in one spot. And Norm going for a level 3 recon comm. I'm not sure what the logic is behind this, especially since they have a Lazarus device and are not resurrecting anything. They have a lot of juicy resurrects, but they aren't doing anything with them.
Well, with the loss of those two jacks. And you're getting all the reclaim. It's hard. Mm-hmm. I see a sumo now. This is the new sumo. I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, the gravity beam sumo. Yes. Pulling stuff in and then stomping on it. Interesting idea. Yeah, it's currently on attract mode and trying to get rid of all these racketeers.
seems to be working.
Just about. Yeah, there we go. Two of the racketeers go down. That's a thug left.
There's one very evil roach here.
And it's pushing away the thug into this, but still the north side's gone. And where is that roach? I want to see that roach wing action. I do not see that roach. I'm sorry, Or is this Norm's roach?
On, Luke, on Norm's commander.
Yeah.
Or left, there's a roach.
Oh, yes.
He's trying to bait the panthers into the roach.
And that's but the only place the panthers can go. I mean, they can go to the north center, but that's really out of position.
I'm not sure if Yurga...
Oh, and Yurga is not going to fall for it quite yet. But still, even if they don't fall for it, there's still a lot of shots that are being knocked in there. I mean, there's all these racketeers coming in here, and then the bandits... If these get hit, the bandits get a bunch of free shots. So even if they don't get hit by that roach, there's still a lot of racketeer shots coming in here that can set up for a bandit push. That happens.
But Yurga wants to park it up. He plays it slowly.
That's the best thing they can do. The Stardust is really the best option. It at least stops that bandit push that's likely to happen.
But now the North is almost has no army left.
Yeah, that Sumo is taking out what it can, pulling constructors away, trying to get through the Stardust.
This is a good moment to add a couple of pyros to do some cleanup.
There are actually a couple of pyros that have been walking around the map. I'm not sure where they've gone off to, if they've been killed or what. But I did see them running around a bit earlier.
The roach has gone off. I missed how many panthers it's got.
Shoot, it got none. I got one. And four bandits. Like, it wasn't particularly effective. That's actually not a bad bait then.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
And,
throwing raiders at a felon
Why?
Is no good
no,
idea.
That's what you're not supposed to do. That's the opposite you're supposed to do. The Jacks and the Sumo, that's what needs to be thrown at it. Although the Jacks and the Sumo are doing a fine job taking out the north.
I see a level 3 commander that is morphing. Okay.
Yeah, Norm is really enjoying this morph for some reason. Like I said, I don't know why they're not using the Lazarus device. They have it. Maybe they just didn't think about it when they were thinking about the commander deaths. But yeah, that roach completely wasted. And now Yurga getting a massive opening, and they're taking it partially. They're still playing it safe. They don't want to commit too much. With that banisher, they could have gotten rid of the bandits. They didn't quite do so, but... Still, it's enough. It is enough. They are getting rid of the bandits, and that, I think, is going to be the opening Yurga needs to get rid of Norm's base. Norm going for the gunship switch, though, and that... Nothing being built for that so far. While at the same time, Yurga going for a cloaky switch, which hasn't actually done anything. But it doesn't matter. RyMarq and Norm throwing the towel. That is game. That's game one, but that was a pretty good game one.
Mm-hmm. I would say, it was RyMarq, a nice one. I liked the jumpies.
Norm, they had a fight. Yeah, I mean, RyMarq really showed that they know how to do jumpies. Just, they got a bit overwhelmed by a shield ball, and the fact they ignored that felon shield ball really didn't help. Especially since that northeast was not rebuilt once the felon shield ball was destroyed. Like, that was a lot of metal that could have been taken back. And that would have helped RyMarq.
Definitely. I think the commander morph was a bit too excessive.
Yeah,
and that one roach, that was a good idea in the south, if you had two or three. I think with roaches, if you want to rely on them for defense, you shouldn't build just one. That's too big of a gamble.
Yeah,
you can put down two or three, and it's not that much more expensive.
Well, the one thing I think that the biggest difference was the fact that Yurga was reclaiming like mad, and Norm and RyMarq, they got some trees, I think, here and there, but they got none of the rocks. And they didn't get very many of the trees either. They just were not reclaiming.
But in the end, they had a better economy.
Did they?
Yeah, halfway through the game. Yeah, they had more metal income from their metal extractors.
Oh, that's true. They had a higher metal production. But they also... They were accessing... Like, RyMarq was accessing hard.
I didn't really look at that.
Now, if you look at this, if you look at the stats, like, they were accessing pretty big.
Of course they want water now.
Yeah, of course they do, because RyMarq being, like I said before, the guy who is person who's been dealing with the Sea Rebalance Project.
Have there been any changes this month?
Mace got nerfed. I don't know. Not much. Like, nothing major.
Okay. There we go again.
Yeah, we're going on Inculta West. which, for those of you who aren't familiar with it, you haven't been watching these tournaments.
Can you still spam a lot of submarines?
I'm guessing so. I don't think there's anything really changed in the meta that makes that impossible. Right. Snakes are still a thing. They can still make them. It's just, I don't know if that's going to happen. Because a lot of people have been opening up with hunters more often. I mean, when people play C, which isn't super common, but yeah. Hunters have been a bit more of a common thing. And that just completely shuts down submarines. Like, early mass hunters just shuts that right down.
Mm-hmm. Do we have a new player, El Babo?
El Babo. I suppose they are, if they've never seen a water match before. Yeah, this is C0K. It's a thing that happens. But yeah, RyMarq is going to the north, going for the shipyard. Norm going for Hovercraft Factory. And this map has shown several times before, but we have had some people asking for a bit more data on the maps, a bit more knowledge about how the maps work. This one's, like a lot of the flatter maps, there isn't much to say. There are some subtle things about ways things to play out at the choke points, but for the most part, it's pretty much open. There's a lot of folks in the center here, some folks in the north and south, because you want to get those resources.
The layout of the metal spots is very important.
The layout of the metal spots is basically everything.
I think it's not evenly distributed. I think you should analyze the gaps, not the the clumps. Well, and for RyMarq, that position, if you want to move forward for expansion, you have a lot of space, a lot of area to cover.
There's this whole spot here that's just right up until the next metal extractor. And even then, there's only about 5 metal extractors right in front of you. And after that, you're straight in the center. You're straight in no man's land, and it's just much harder. So typically, you'll see players in the north try to take this north crescent and not worry about the center dozen or so. Similarly,
yeah, you
players
can get
in the south.
The 9 metal spots on the right side, or its mirrored position in the lower left.
Mm-hmm.
Those are easy. But it's just, how do you approach the entering of the middle of the map? Over the top maxes, through the center, do you leave it to your ally, like Norm?
Well,
RyMarq
is going for C, so I wouldn't be surprised if RyMarq went for some subs and tried to bring them along the north side of the map and just completely bypass most of the main sides. Just go along the north and then attack from the north. Anarchid, however, is also going for shipyards at the north side of the map, and Yurga going for ships at the south side. So the only non-ship player right now is Norm going for hovercraft. Going for quick dagger, and RyMarq is in fact going for mass snake. Or a decent amount of snake. Snake mariner. So it's not quite mass yet.
So is Yurga, he wants snakes?
Yeah, I think Yurga might be doing the mirror strategy, going along the south side of the map and trying
and
to hit Norm
snakes
from the south. Yeah, none of the players going for hunters. Very bizarre.
Why would you want to hunter so early?
Well, if you're calling, I think it's more of a read, but if you think your opponents are going to be going for mass snakes, going for mass hunters shuts it down.
Yeah, but up until now, nobody had seen each other's factories yet.
And that's true. It's one of the things.
They're expensive. Hunters are expensive. Snakes are fast, and you can use them for scouting.
However, this is probably going to go down to the daggers right now.
Oh, wow. Look at those
daggers are really
daggers.
Good anti-sub.
I didn't realize this.
Oh, yeah. Gauss has been able to hit underwater for the last couple months now. I think even the last tournament it came up. But at this point, Yurga able to get that sub away from there. And Anarchid is going for some hunters now that they know. Actually, they don't really know much, but they are going for hunters. Which is a good thing to do. It's going to stop RyMarq cold. And RyMarq looks like they're trying to rethink.
One.
Okay, so at this point, Norm managing to get a metal extractor for the cost of a couple daggers. And this second snake is not quite coming in. Yurga's commander is taking a fair amount of damage, but that urchin will stop everything cold.
If you can get raiders in the early game to shoot your commander, then that is good.
Yeah, that's kind of a waste of power. I mean, at that point, no. Indeed. They should be hitting the metal extractors. They should be hitting the wind generators. Hitting the commander, there's too much health there. You're not going to deal any meaningful damage unless you kill, and you're not going to kill.
Not with two raiders.
Okay, and RyMarq going for anti-sub, going for hunters, and going for skeeters. So anti-sub, anti-heavy. I don't understand the skeeter part, though. I think they might be predicting...
Scouting?
I think maybe they're thinking Anarchid's going to go for... either hunters of their own, or maybe try to go for a quick enforcer or typhoon or crusader. Stuff that the executors can just shut down directly with disarm.
Mm-hmm.
That seems what they're probably
RyMarq has a constructor in the center. And a commander taking the back maxes. Anarchid does the opposite. He just moves forward with his commander and lets the boat take the back maxes.
Honestly, I agree with RyMarq more on this map. Only on this map. Only because of the fact that commanders cannot really operate underwater. If it was any land map, the opposite needs to be the case. The commander needs to be up front. But in this map, the commander is defenseless. So that totally makes sense to do it this
way. Agreed. Yeah, you could also use that commander as a nano turret. At your factory.
Yeah,
let it build all the economy. Nice and I think everyone in this game could do with more constructors.
Yeah,
if
surprising.
I just compare this to your regular Comet Catcher game or other big map games, you want to have more constructors.
Well, Mariners are very expensive for constructors. That is the one thing.
200. It's okay.
200, 7.5 metal per second. Quills are about... they're a decent cost. 150 is pretty normal. But for Mariners, yeah, I could see building only like half as many Mariners as you'd normally have constructors in any other land game.
But... look at the income now.
26-26 versus 20-21. Your
Anarchids are really running away.
They're getting up there already. They have expanded a bit faster. They do have the worker advantage. And that has helped. Yes. And RyMarq actually being quite gutsy. They've been pushing forward very strongly. But even then, there's not a lot to be said about this. It's just they're pushing forward and that's... They've just been doing it slower. Not to mention, Norm and Anarchid both are accessing metal. Neither of them yet are actually getting a nano tower on there. There's no caretaker so far, and these quills... Norm is not using the quill gear to actually build up more in their factory. They're not pushing their factory, and they really should be. And RyMarq now getting the excess points as well. Part of that, however, is the lack of power, or lack of energy.
Yes, Norm and RyMarq need to practice that bit.
Yeah, getting energy on... getting power on the sea is a little bit tricky, because you basically have plus 1.2 all the time. You don't get solars... Well, you sort of do if you want to build them on the ridges, but basically you don't get solars. You get tidal generators. You need to build twice as many as you'd normally build solars.
I really like this typhoon, by the way. It's quite ballsy to move into torpedo launchers, but it works out.
Well, the typhoons have the health to deal with it, but now at this point it's going to be typhoon on typhoon. No, typhoon on... What's typhoon on typhoon? The other typhoon didn't even attack. What the heck? That was bizarre. Okay. There we go. Regardless, Anarchid managing with their own typhoons to get in and tear apart RyMarq's typhoon, because while the torpedo launcher doesn't do much, the other typhoons most certainly do. And now, two typhoons for Anarchid compared to none for RyMarq. Oh, hey! Yurga, the most entertaining unit in the game! As people will see very shortly. When it starts to go off.
But it didn't.
Or die, and... Wow,
Yurga only wants to make submarines. He isn't interested in any other unit.
And yet, RyMarq is not going heavy hunter. I mean, the Skeeter kind of makes
sense.
I'm
still not sure how good they are.
In large groups, they are very powerful. I mean, considering that they are twice the cost of snakes, but yeah, they are actually quite powerful in groups.
A complete salvo doesn't kill a snake.
No, Crusaders are a bit more useful. But Crusaders are far more expensive as well. Although, I suppose not that much more expensive. They're... 550. That's something like three submarines, and that's going to be quite powerful. And it's also going to be anti-building as well. But now the downside is, of course, the Typhoon's coming in, and these Hunters are not going to be able to do too much against them. They're going to be able to do some decent damage, though. Hunter versus Typhoon in large numbers, Hunters win.
But if you can, if you look at the south and how Jurg is playing, each time he moves in with those submarines, makes a couple of kills and he gets back.
And none of them have died. Although the typhoons are going into their deaths. Looks like they
would be nice if Jurg was there with his submarines now.
Down goes one of the typhoons. The second typhoon is apparently going to be able to get out of there, but it's still in enemy territory. In fact, no, the hunters are stopping it. And down it goes. That typhoon down. None of the hunters died. Anarchid lost both of those for free in enemy territory.
Yes, and
everyone's accessing.
Yurga was just standing by and doing nothing.
Yep, absolutely providing no help whatsoever. Yurga just watched and laughed. Not being quite the best teammate. And Anarchid losing yet another Typhoon. Or very nearly losing another Typhoon. And now Yurga falls in. Although admittedly, those are Hunters. They're kind of scary. But even then, that didn't take much to kill. There's eight. There are eight subs. There are eight snakes. It's not going to be hard to deal with, even when you're dealing with the type counter.
The Crusader is here.
I don't see a Crusader around here.
Yurga has a Crusader.
Ah, that's why, because I'm looking at the right player. Yeah, there we go. Yurga has the counter unit that RyMarq needs. Oops. That or just more Hunters, but yeah, that's...
Income-wise, it's... No, Norm and RyMarq have slightly bigger income now.
Yeah, and no one's accessing anymore.
Or not. Yeah, well, it's about even. Let's.
Yeah, Yurga has the highest income, then Anarchid is the lowest. Overall, still fairly even. And Anarchid about to lose their... Well, not going to lose their commander. Their commander's getting attacked, but it's not going to be...
One shot... Those submarines are so fast, and they do a one-hit kill on those daggers.
On the skeeters? Yeah, the skeeters and daggers. Claymore's trying to deal with that. And actually, Anarchid's commander is going to go down. Did go down. That's a big blow. But Anarchid switching over to Amphib.
Here comes my favorite unit, Scallop.
Yeah, Anarchid switched over to Amphib, as has RyMarq. And Scallop is the best unit to use in this case. Pretty much, in general, if you're doing a team game with Amp, just go for Scallop, don't go for Duck. Scallops just tear apart anything on the surface. They throw depth charges everywhere and just clear it out.
It's a suicidal Claymore. Oh boy, you can only... No, that doesn't work.
Yeah, the Claymore's gonna have a hard time dealing with a lot of damage. It's... I'm not sure how that's gonna
help.
Build
its own army.
Yeah, Claymores are still a little bit tricky to get right. However, the Crusaders aren't really gonna do too much. And
you should not shoot
Metal Treasures with Claymores. Well, that's a one-shot kill, and that Claymore, I mean, the Claymores do a nice... Wow, that's a lot of damage. As long as they're careful not to get too close, they actually annihilate these things. I mean, the entire subline's basically gone now. Yurga switched over entirely to Crusaders, mind you, but still, the entire snake line is dead. Except for two. And that can be taken out fairly quickly with these Hunters.
Have you shown the area of effect of the Claymore?
I don't know if I can. Oh, yeah, I can. Yeah, that's... Yeah, that little glowing red target circle there. That's the area of effect. It's huge. It's almost their range, actually. That's the tough part with using them. If they're not at max range, they knock themselves away. And hurt themselves badly.
But there's light unit attacks from Norm. They're not really helping in the long.
No, but at the same time... Oh, wow, nice shot there. Getting rid of Typhoon after Typhoon.
Shit, was blown out
and
of
Mariner.
The water.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Claymore is the most entertaining unit, just the way the physics interactions work. But RyMarq actually getting quite the nice army of Hunters and does get a Crusader of their own. So they do have their own Crusaders.
Just one big pile of long-range bombard.
Yeah, over in the
south. Will be hard to deal with this.
Yeah, RyMarq is slowly but surely taking the center, and they have their... They're going for Ducks against Scallops. Unsurprisingly, the Ducks do not win. As mentioned before, Scallops are the best thing to use when you're dealing with combination of Sea and Amphib. And Norm moving in with more Claymores, just trying to annihilate things with Claymores, which is actually working out pretty decently, but not
right,
as well as they'd like.
Epic economy.
Yeah, Rammer's a
But you might want to share some of this with Norm.
Well, that should be automatic. And Norm at this point... Yeah, I see what you mean, though. Might want to actually pull in the overdrive. The overdrive is being connected
some,
along.
Some of his army to the south, because his ally cannot handle this much longer.
No, Norm is losing units after units. Norm losing army after army. And the Claymore's doing a decent job. The Dagger's actually doing okay. But the Sniper sub coming, actually, the Serpent here should be destroyed by the Claymore pretty quick. But the Typhoon is the real problem. The Typhoon is going to get hit. I mean, this Claymore is going to blow itself up. Not quite. It got it out of the way, but still doesn't deal enough damage. And Rymark's forces are taking... No, they're way over to the north. Way out of position. Lots of Hunters, but while that's very useful, they are not in the right position. And Norm, once again, pushing another big push.
It's another waste.
Yeah, another...
It doesn't serve any purpose in the long run. It's just...
Just wave
even
after
wave
of death.
Fully, you lose.
Yeah, with all the mariners in the center of the map, Yurga is taking all that reclaim. Most of Yurga's economy right now is that reclaim, and they are making full use of it in terms of their army value. I mean, 12k army at this point.
Yeah, it's 15 against 10 in army value.
And RyMarq and Yurga have not met up, and I think that's the biggest thing right now, is that both players are attacking the weaker opponent. But RyMarq not pushing in as hard as... Well, RyMarq hasn't pushing in that hard yet. Yurga's playing it very
safe.
Start
his own reclaim. There's a lot of metal in the center here.
Mm-hmm. And there are no constructors to deal with it. There's a couple mariners, but they are just assisting.
Yes, and that's something that Yurga is very good at.
Idle mariner. Why is RyMarq leaving mariners idle? That should not happen at all. That's just wrong.
It happens to everyone on this map.
Yeah, that's true. There's a lot of stuff going on.
I think this is a good game, but Yurga is really becoming a problem.
Well, yeah, Norm is holding their own as best they can.
RyMarq, I think you're going to just select this entire army, move it to the right. I think he'll win.
Yeah, Yurga will definitely take out Norm that way. RyMarq, I think, is trying to take out Anarchid at the same time and then essentially go one-on-one against Yurga. I think that's RyMarq's plan. Although, no, never mind. RyMarq actually moving south, trying to get rid of some of Yurga's forces head-on before annihilating an Anarchid's.
Yurga is very passive.
Yeah, Yurga is playing like clone right now. Actually, more like clone
turrets
than clone.
And defenders.
Like, they're not attacking very much at all. And that's working out fine. They've got a massive army. They can push in whenever they'd like. But I think they just want to let Norm throw a few more waves of units away beforehand. Now, with all these daggers, that might be a mistake. But the dagger's coming in through a fairly weak point. I'm thinking Norm's going to lose a lot of this, and there's still a lot of damage that it's kind of unnecessary. Still a lot of metal being thrown away. But it's doing a bit of cutting off, getting rid of, or at least damaging a few mariners, getting rid of a crusader, or two, or maybe even three, I'm not sure. Those urchins are stopping the typhoons cold, however. And there is a rightward move for Yurga over the southeast side of the map. Should
that's
be able
what
to
we were
Norm's
talking
base.
About.
Yeah, that's exactly the thing. So Yurga not being completely passive, and Anarchid getting a warlord because why not? And indeed, why not? That's the only Strider hub so far.
Well, the army values have evened up a bit, but he'll lose his production now. At this point, RyMarq should add nano turrets like crazy because Norm will lose his production.
Yeah, so at this point it's going to be RyMarq getting a lot of metal, Norm getting nothing.
Well, yeah, evil typhoons.
Well, those typhoons, they did their job. They annihilated Norm's base, and Norm had no other backup factories. Now, I'm curious what Norm is going to plan to do afterwards, because Norm right now has no factories. They do, I think, have some quills. I think. If not, they can get a Marino donated to them, so not the biggest deal. And they do have their commander, so they're not completely out in the water. They're not completely... Well, I just want to say high and dry, but... Yeah. They aren't. They're still wet, I suppose. I guess that's a good thing in this game. And that Warlord is almost done.
Yeah, that will be a big game changer.
That will probably
seal it. I don't see any type of error, by the way.
Yeah, it hasn't happened a whole lot this tournament so far. It just there was one error play in game two of the last round. That was it. And RyMarq coming in, losing all their forces to the Crusaders. Like, this is basically suicide. They get rid of a Crusader here and there, but that's
feeding reclaim. Well, but this one of the sniper subs can die now. And that's a big loss. They are so expensive.
But
at least used to be.
Yo, they still are. They are still
1,000, yeah.
Yeah. They are still costly. Very costly little things. And Norm going for a second Hovercraft factory. So rebuilding the Hovercraft factory and getting a lot of nanotech.
RyMarq is accessing. Or not RyMarq, I mean Norm is accessing. There should be more build power.
Is excessive.
More ring climb.
Yeah, but they have 50 build power at this factory over the south now. So they're good.
It's okay. It's okay.
Right now, what they need is energy. Oh, yeah. Well, so Yurga is managing to sweep in along the north, getting rid of RyMarq's forces with all these Skeeters, stopping anything that RyMarq... Oh, then RyMarq at the same time also going for Mass Skeeter. Both players trying for the same thing, and the Mass Skeeter makes a lot of sense for RyMarq, given the Crusaders. Stops them dead. And also against the Warlord, that's going to help out a lot. That is by far the best move against this Warlord. Not sure, I mean, it wasn't predicted. But yeah, Mass Skeeter is about the only thing that can really be done. Just disarm out that
doesn't
Warlord.
Doesn't kill much, but... I'll see you next Christmas, anything. But that's to...
next week?
That's sooner than I thought. Than it usually is.
Although the Duck's actually doing a... the Duck's doing a formidable job.
Of course, yes. The Skeeters cannot hit underwater.
Yeah, and the Duck's actually fast enough to catch up to us, so...
The Warlord is here, it's almost dead. Wow.
Yeah, the Warlord is, if not dead at least, has been pushed back quite a lot, giving RyMarq enough breathing room to deal with Yurga's forces sort of. But Yurga has taken over most of the map, taken out that second hovercraft platform before anything gets built out of it. All the ducks are dead, the Warlord being pulled back to repair, and a reef coming in afterwards. RyMarq hasn't gotten much. But what they do have is a boatload of ducks and some scallops being built up. That's about it. Actually, a lot of scallops too, but the scallops are getting torn apart by Yurga scallops. And, of course, Yurga's surface force is helping out with that as well. And Yurga tearing apart Norm's forces entirely. I mean, at this point, Yurga's basically just coming in for a sweep. They're going to take out Norm from the south, move north, tear apart the rest, and that's going to be game. Though RyMarq, they do have a lot of scallops to deal with this with. And a lot of ducks as well. A lot of ducks, a lot of scallops.
Yo.
Though mostly ducks. And that's going to fall down to the scallops pretty quick.
Yeah. The passive-aggressive style of Yurga won the game, and Norm fell for it. He just kept feeding and suiciding his own army. He wasn't growing while Yurga was.
Yeah, and that is a common, as I mentioned before, common low to mid-level error, is to think that you have to hit your opponent always. Harassing is the most important thing, to the point that it doesn't matter if you lose units in the process of trying, that you have to do it, otherwise you're going to lose. Not considering the fact that you might just be losing so many units that it doesn't matter that you're damaging any economy. You've been just feeding
exactly.
them metal. Not to mention, your army has not been growing, so your army size has been remaining constant. Their army has been growing because they haven't been losing units in the process. At this point, Norm once again completely crippled. RyMarq doing fairly well for themselves, but this is 2v2, not 1v1.
Yeah. Good showing by RyMarq. Good game.
Yeah, I mean, they're definitely showing that they do have the knowledge of the sea. No enforcers yet so far, surprisingly enough, but yeah, they've switched heavily to... I'm surprised that no enforcers, though. They actually would do a decent job against the hunters. But no, that is not happening. And the Warlord is up. The Warlord is firing, trying to get rid of this over here, and not actually doing much, except...
It's a defender.
Yeah.
Must be the only one on the map.
It was, until it smashed it. Yeah, the Warlord is basically just hitting based on radar. There's not a whole lot of radar coverage of what RyMarq has. In fact, Anarchid and Yurga don't really know a whole lot of what RyMarq has at the moment. The Warlord is hitting what it can. It hasn't hit the Amphib Factory yet, but if it does, that is going to be a major blow. I mean, granted, the Commander Shields are doing what they can. A RyMarq's Commander with Area Shield and Personal Shield doing a great job of protecting that. And it'll help a lot once the Warlord comes up to it. But at this point, yeah, not happening. Anarchid not paying much attention to that. Oh, and it looks like Yurga is going for an air switch. And looks like I have to change the size of this thing. About time we finally get an air switch in this game. In a 2v2, who knew? Yeah, for those of you who aren't familiar, air is more common in 2v2 than the tournaments tend to make it appear to be. Like, having one player go for air is pretty typical. And having an air switch in this game in general is very typical. The fact that it took 20 minutes to get an air switch is... That doesn't happen. Normally it takes 6 to 10.
Look at
bizarre.
All the metal RyMarq is getting now from that massive army of constructors reclaiming.
Oh, wow. I can't actually. I have to turn the font size down because I can't see it. It's 100. It was in the hundreds. And RyMarq's pushing all that into new amphibs and into new ships.
Yes.
But yeah, surprisingly, getting some serpents, but no enforcers.
Resurrecting
no
Athenas. Anarchid is just playing now. It's toying.
Yeah. I mean, those ducks could be scary if they get close to this enforcer.
No, they're free.
No, never mind. There's hunters in the way. Thunder's stopping that from happening. They're not going to make the same mistake as last time. But that shield is doing a pretty decent job.
So far, yeah.
Well, the warlord hasn't hit anything yet.
Skirmishers, those boys. Boys.
And the boys, they aren't going to help too much. They're going to try. Actually, they can get rid of the hunters pretty well. They're out of range enough.
Yes,
yeah, they can get rid of the hunters just fine. So if they get rid of the hunters, then the ducks can follow up. And that's exactly what's needed. I don't know if that's going to happen, though.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Yurga's army. Yurga's army of mariners. Forget Yurga's army of anything else. Just mariners. Like, 30 mariners.
the warlord is dead.
Oh shoot, I missed that.
Yeah, there were a couple of typhoons that charged on it.
Yeah, they're down it goes, sinking into the ocean.
Oh boy, Norm is lagging out. I think we should pull. Oh no, he's not. He had a lag spike.
And the reef has been completed. As the warlord dies, the reef is completed, and the warlord doesn't even end up really underwater. That's how big this thing is. The wreck does not completely get underwater. Yeah, it's a new reef model. Anarchid's new reef.
Whoa. Nice.
Nice drone bays on the side and the hangars at the top.
It's a bit bulky in the lower part.
Yeah, but it looks cool.
It looks cool.
There's no denying it looks cool. It should also be a bit more accurate. A bit easier to get rid of a lot of these forces that have been just running around. But once again, more scalps coming in to try to take it out from the bottom. And getting rid of a few drones here, and they're not really damaging the reef too much. Dealing a bit of damage, but not all that much. And RyMarq still getting heavily surrounded. They're holding their own pretty well, but Anarchid and Yurga, I think, can just move in and kill.
Norm really has problems. He has 15 seconds lag now.
I don't know if that matters so much. Norm is basically dead anyway.
No, but it's still in it.
Yeah,
the north is going well, so it's important. There could be room for a comeback.
That's true, actually. You know, Norm could rebuild. They are Lazarusing, so that's actually a bit of a ban.
No,
they are Lazarusing Typhoons, too.
So referring to RyMarq, if he can turn this around.
Well, RyMarq's like, only one with units right
Yurga
now.
Yurga kills Norm, and RyMarq kills Anarchid.
Yeah, well, as I mentioned before, is that that would happen, and then RyMarq and Yurga would 1v1. But I think Yurga would win that. Fairly certain that would happen, in fact. The only way around it would be if the Crusaders were tearing apart by a ton of Skeeters and a ton of Hunters. And RyMarq doesn't really have many of either. So I don't see that happening. Or a ton of Typhoons, that works too. But once again, not enough of them for that to happen. Scalp's trying to do what they can, but
planes.
They are not coming in hard enough.
Shadows are building up. Or what are the Swifts? No, Ravens.
Ravens, yeah. Formerly referred to as Shadows, but now called Ravens.
Oh, what was the arm bomber called again?
I don't remember. I'm sorry.
I should
know
this. I should know this. Wow.
I probably should too, but yeah, it doesn't matter. Anyway, RyMarq and Norm throwing intel after 25 hard-fought minutes.
Yeah, good game, guys. This was very enjoyable.
Yeah, that was definitely... That was a worthy fight. They fought well. There is no denying that. RyMarq and Norm fought well, made a good counterpick map choice, and they dealt with Yurga and Anarchid fairly intelligently. But yeah, Yurga was just left a bit too much of their own devices and not attacked intelligently enough. Their army was not torn down before it got... way out of hand, because this one is like 28,000 metal worth of army. That is way too much. I mean, the sheer amount of Crusaders... How many Crusaders? There was over a dozen Crusaders.
Yep.
And it was just pumping them out. And that was that. That's semifinals round one.
Okay, what about Moj and Sino? They're both here?
That game hasn't been done yet. That game is halfway through.
Oh, they're still playing. Okay. Maybe we can join in and get their third game or second game. I'll get a status update.
Okay, cool. So we'll see what's going on in that one. And that was... Yeah, that's... Like I said, not surprising. RyMarq made a lot of right calls.
Wait, but are they even playing?
Oh, they're playing. I think. The game in progress. It's playing. It's been going on for 12 minutes. Okay, they're around 3 minutes into game 2, so they're probably about done. Not sure who won game 1, though.
Wait. Maybe...
Okay, Moj and Sino are leading. Yeah, Moj and Sino apparently leading as Icons and Killer, so if they win, that is game 2. We're on the semifinals. Okay, so yeah, RyMarq apparently doesn't like relying on amphibious bots, but doesn't have an easy way to keep tracking units other than amphib? Cannot keep track of all your units. I'm curious. Because I would think amph would be a lot harder to keep track of units in, because all units are underground and they're underwater, and it's just trying to see what they all are. Okay, so apparently really ships are more of an APM sink than amphibs are? I guess scallops are much of an APM sink. I can see that. Ships and...
I don't know. Because they turn so slow, you have to babysit the units, maybe?
What the hell? Okay, I apologize for the firecrackers in the background. I'm not sure what's going on there.
Oh, I thought it was... 0K sounds.
No, that's firecrackers going off in my backyard, apparently. No clue why. December 20th. I don't know.
Cannot start soon enough.
Woo. That seems to have finished. Anyway, so we're going to be coming back, I guess, whenever... I mean, unless you want to talk about the game more. I don't really see much more to be said.
I'm in Moj and Icons game now.
Okay. How's it looking? Is it looking like Moj and Icon is going to... Sorry. Moj and Sino are going to win?
No.
Okay.
I think it's worth... watching the third game. But they're not reading my chat message.
Okay, well, anyway, I guess I will just hang out and wait for that to happen. But anyway, until that happens, I think we're going to go to intermission.
So, I'll give... Yeah.
So stay tuned, everyone. We're going to have a short intermission and then come back to either... It's either going to be the Moj, Sino, Icons, Killer Game 3, or it's going to be semifinals with Moj, Sino versus Skazi and Orphelius. So whichever one it is, stay tuned. It'll be up in just a moment. Well, a few minutes.